today, Oceanport Cares was very fortunate to have the volunteers come from a local church, and they've gone to several of our homes here in Oceanport where the residents were out of their homes displaced by the storm. After lifting and inside repairs, they're now back in their homes to some degree and just need that extra help with finishing things around their property, moving things out of storage back into their house. And these homeowners, throughout all this recovery process, have been the same people offering their help to their neighbors. It's a real amazing phenomenon to see people like Bobby need the help, but be the first one to offer help to someone else. Oceanport Care started literally the day after the storm, almost a year ago. A core group of volunteers, Chrissy, Wendy, Chris, Buzz, they got together and thought of ways to help our town. And the wonderment of that small act of kindness on our behalf triggered people from literally as far away as Washington State and Florida to come to Oceanport on their days off for a week at a time in the hot summer. They rolled up their sleeves, they opened their hearts, brought their toolboxes and their bagged lunches, and came every day, 5 days in a row, helping tear out sheetrock, put in floor joists, put up floorboards, walls, you name it, move bushes, cut down trees. The outpouring of support from people far and wide who never even heard about Oceanport has touched so many lives here. They've truly impacted homeowners. And me, who wasn't even affected by the storm, cannot believe the outpouring of kindness and support. If you have an hour to spare or a week that people have given, it will truly be cherished and remembered for a lifetime. You just can't imagine how truly appreciated it is. Bobby and his family suffered probably the extreme loss from the storm. And yet he was the first one there way back in October helping other people in need. So if you're willing to help, just know that the people you help are always the first person offering help for the next person. There's nothing like it.
Hi, my name is Mary. I'm in New Jersey. I was a victim of Hurricane Sandy, and I have lived in this house all my life. I'm not giving it up. I am a widow. I work with a school teacher's salary, so insurance didn't cut it, credit cards didn't cut it, and if it wasn't for the volunteers, I don't know how I would have ever gotten anything done outside my property. All right, I am so grateful for the three groups that I've had come. They've helped me move large pieces of furniture. They've helped me lay carpeting down. I've had people come and clean out my whole garage. Still working on the garage, and now I have some people here helping me with the yard work. It's a wonderful thing. I am also a volunteer too, so whenever you can give back, it makes you feel good. I had two groups come from some churches in West Virginia. They were a lot of fun, strong college students, very, very helpful. I've had people from a church locally now in New Jersey, and they're the ones helping me today in the background. And I think that they're doing a wonderful job, and I also have participated in volunteer activities also. In the long run, if it wasn't for the volunteers coming and helping, I would still be probably in another home. I'm so grateful that I had the help for moving furniture, which is something that I wasn't able to do. I'm grateful to have the help on the outside, which when you're not here for a while, nature tries to take over. And Hurricane Sandy has had a great impact financially and emotionally on myself and a lot of people in my neighborhood. It'll be a long time before we really feel like we're back to normal again, and we continue to need help. So if there are volunteer groups out there, don't give up on us yet. We still need you.
Hi, my name is Mil Dranoff. I'm the Baron Builders Coordinator at the Washington, D.C. Jewish Community Center. We're here in New Jersey this weekend volunteering to put together some houses after Hurricane Sandy. We're really excited to be here. Right now we're working on the Jefferson House. We've been doing some aluminum siding and some painting of the shed in the back and of the exterior of the house. And we can't wait to keep on working throughout the weekend. If you want to follow us, you can do it on Facebook at Washington DC JCC, on Twitter at 16th Street J, or on Instagram at DC_JCC.
We're on Wygant Street here in Port Richmond, the North Shore section of Staten Island. This entire street was devastated by Sandy. All five of these houses washed out. You can see they're in different stages of disarray. One house behind me is full of mold. It's very obvious if you just peek in the window. All of these houses were inhabited by undocumented immigrants, very low-wage immigrant workers and their families. And they were displaced because of Sandy. Some of them are still in the evacuation center today. Others are living with family and friends. This just is really an example of the vast reach of Sandy's devastation for Staten Island. We think of it as the South and East Shore devastation, but here on the North Shore as well, there were hundreds of families affected. So I'm from Project Hospitality, and we are an interfaith effort that works with hungry and homeless people. So this was a natural for us to become involved in the disaster. At first, our work centered on evacuating people the day before the storm and then providing for evacuation space during the storm, after the storm, and continue to run the evacuation centers today, 10 months later. In the weeks after the storm, we gathered clergy from an array of different denominations and affiliations, Jewish clergy and Muslim, and Hindu and Christian, Catholic, to ask ourselves the question of where we could be of most help, how the churches and how the houses of worship could continue to provide support in the disaster areas, and how we were going to organize that support to people on the ground, the different hubs and points of distribution. And we began meeting November 12th, 2 weeks after the disaster. By December 27th, we had pretty much formed ourselves into a coalition, and in January, visited by FEMA to hear from them that we were actually at the seed planting of the long-term recovery organization for Staten Island, which is what we've become. We're now an 85-member coalition. We span additional coalitions that have joined on to us, including Connect to Recovery, which is a Jewish coalition. And all of us together are working voluntarily on the rebuild effort. And these groups, if they're unskilled laborers, there's plenty to be done in terms of providing food to the disaster area, doing housing needs and assessment surveys, and going door to door to find out what people's needs are, hosting help fairs for the different Sandy families. And for the skilled laborers, there's houses to rebuild one house at a time. We had 22,000 households affected here in Staten Island, 7,000 people displaced, several hundred people still displaced and not in their homes today. One of the great coordinating features is of this coalition, of this long-term recovery organization, is our ability to garner the help of our houses of worship to host groups that are coming in to do the recovery work. So from Temple Emmanuel here in Port Richmond and Faith United Methodist Church to the Presbyterians and the Lutherans and the interdenominational churches and our Pentecostal churches, we are able to house groups of up to 60 volunteers at a clip and provide for them appropriate showers. Our local Moravian church, New York Moravian Church, is hosting our showers for all of our volunteers that need showering. We're able to get the word out to folks that we're available. There's some cost incurred to help the churches where it's needed, and where it's not needed, we're able to do this for free. But we have to provide for volunteers to come in because this is a long recovery. There are so many houses that need to be repaired. There are so many lives that need to be restored, and we need all of the help, hands on deck, to make us accomplish house to house the restoration to the fullest degree possible of every family affected by Sandy and suffering by Sandy today.
Hi, my name is Damon Pearson. I'm from Christ Church of Howell, New Jersey, and we're coming out to try to assist a lot of our community members here that are still affected by Hurricane Sandy. We're coming out to try to assist. Some of us have skills, some of us do not, but there's such a great need here in our community for us to band together across faith lines, across different differences, so that way we can help build up our communities. We're really having a great time and having an opportunity to help homes that are still being affected. The gentleman here at this house was in disrepair, and not only was different organizations coming from different walks of life, different economic backgrounds, different cultural differences, coming together for this area, for the New Jersey area, for those who are really affected by Hurricane Sandy. So we're really, really happy, and we're really fortunate about this opportunity, and we would just want to encourage as many people, please come out, even if it's just for a day, a few hours. There's a lot of work that needs to be done in our shore area, and we would really love for you to come out to be a part of what this community is doing to help build the Jersey Shore. Thank you.
Join the cleanup crew and St. Bernard Project in making a difference at the Jersey Shore.
Hi, I'm Maureen Campbell, and I work for Jersey Central Power and Light. I'm with the Forestry Department, and I'm working for United Way to help the people in Union Beach get back into their homes as soon as possible. So, we were prepared before the devastation. We had to shut down temporarily because when it gets to a certain, where nobody can go out. But I don't think any of us were prepared after Sandy, the hurricane was over, to, in my lifetime, I'd never witnessed such devastation. The sad part about it is there's still people in my community, in these communities, that still are not in their home, and that is overwhelming for me. It's just something I can't comprehend, that they are not in their homes. So with that said, our company is generous in that they allowed us to come, and it's strictly just to help people who are in need. That's the only reason I do it. I would hope that if I were in their position, that there would be people out there to help me, because you can't do it by yourself. Today we're working on a home that is being demolished, and we are saving this homeowner a tremendous amount of money. If we did not accomplish this, they would have to hire a contractor. So it makes me feel better that at least that money can be spent on other things, that person doesn't have to hire a demolition crew. And the one thing that we should all emphasize, we are all just do our job. We're not experienced, but yet we're helping. So you don't have to feel that you know how to drive a nail or paint. You know, we're all helping, and we're getting something accomplished. And so I hope that people aren't thinking that they don't know how to do something, so they don't volunteer. The need is there. There's always something to be found.
My name is Brian Gingrich Jr. I'm from Westfield, New Jersey. I work with AmeriCorps with United Way of Monmouth County. We're here to rebuild homes from Hurricane Sandy. Probably worked on maybe over 35 houses already.
Everybody in our area is capable of doing what I am doing today. I have no expertise in this, but I'm certainly, with the efforts of myself, my fellow co-workers, and the other people here, we're achieving a tremendous task.
The one house that we found was in Long Branch. The house was built in 1894. It was a family of generation house. We met the homeowner, Farah, and her grandfather owned the house, her father lived in this house, and there's, you find pictures underneath all the houses. You found like names on the property, like originally foundation. It was very emotional, and she'll cry. And we kind of know the pain, since we've heard different stories about Sandy. Everybody has a story, but this one did touch us a lot. To everybody out there watching this, come on out, volunteer. We do need help. You know, we work in Union Beach. You know, 2,100 homes were damaged or destroyed, and only maybe 20% of it's done after almost 3 years. We need help, you know. Luckily, we have the Travel TV helping us, giving us stories to make sure we find people that cares and hopefully help other people, because right now, we need all the help we need right now.
So I really encourage everyone to take a moment, look around, and volunteer. The littlest task goes a long way.
My name is Bill Futornik. I am the Ritual Director of Congregation Beth Jacob in Redwood City, California. And I brought a group of teenagers mostly, and actually a group last week as well, to Long Island to work with Nechama, which is the Jewish response to disaster. And we're here to rebuild houses. And we're here to help those who were affected by Hurricane Sandy. And we're here to really volunteer and give our time to improve the world. I discovered there's only really one organization, Jewish organization, that was a disaster relief organization. That's Nechama. And I contacted them, and they were very quick to get back to me, and they just seemed incredibly well organized around this effort. And they said, well, you know, as far as Oklahoma goes, we don't know how much longer we'll be there, but the Sandy rebuilding is going on for another year, which was very surprising to me because, you know, the hurricane hits in October, and for a year and a half, they're going to have to rebuild. The minute it leaves the newspaper, it seems to leave our consciousness. Once you get on the ground and do it, you kind of see, yeah, you know, that was a pretty transforming experience. And I know that the group I had last week felt pretty transformed by the experience. You know, in this group, we've been having little debriefs at night, and the teens are saying, you know, how incredibly grateful they feel. And if nothing else, it'll make you feel very grateful for the life that you have.
My name is Sasha, and I'm here. I'm coming from Las Vegas, Nevada. And for half my life, I was in prison, and I just feel like I'm spending the second half of my life fixing what I did in the first. And it's just a really wonderful thing to working with these people, and just the most rewarding thing I've ever done. Volunteering, I would say, is the absolute most rewarding thing I've ever done, and it's just so nice being able to help people in need, and it's just, I'd recommend it to anybody.
I'm Dahlia Jude, and we're in Massapequa, New York, rebuilding homes after Hurricane Sandy. I decided to come here because I figured to make good of my summer of my free time and volunteer with something that I was passionate about and help with what I could. We've been on this house for the whole time so far, just the two of us.
My relative's house burned down in a fire locally, and I knew like what devastation like came to them, and I wanted to help people like them during my summer. I'm from San Francisco, California, and we're working with Nechama. We're here for 5 days. Even if you don't have any experience like building homes, or like you've never done anything like this, to like come in here and make such a difference, or at least make a little bit of a difference, is like means a lot to me, that I can like learn and kind of just help someone out in any way that I can by being here and doing just my part.
I think the best part of the volunteer experience is seeing the progress we've made on the houses just over a couple of days, and seeing how happy the people who live here are with the work we're doing. I would say it's worth it. It's worth the unpleasant weather and the hard work you do all day, because at the end of the day, you feel like you're really making a difference, and that's more than you would make by not doing it. So you feel not only good about yourself, but you feel good about the work you're doing and the people you're helping. So I would just say it's a great experience, and I recommend it.
My name is Mark Rupert. I'm pastor of First Presbyterian Church in Akron, Ohio. We brought a group out from our church yesterday. And we are here to help through the Presbyterian Disaster Assistance Program. We are trying to get mold out from the basement, and then they're just taking all kind of things that have collected over the time out of the second and third floor. We went to Gulfport, Mississippi after Hurricane Katrina hit, and so we were working down there out of a Presbyterian church, also with Presbyterian Disaster Assistance Program. Our group really wants to be Jesus to others, and to be his example, and to come alongside other people that are in need. Get in touch with the Presbyterian Disaster Assistance Program. They can go online and just volunteer.
My name is Dick Hillebrand from First Presbyterian Church in Akron, Ohio. We're a group of nine people here today, helping out in Queens, New York on Rockaway Beach. And we're just here to do what we can to clean up after Hurricane Sandy. We've taken a trip, several trips before. We went to Alaska about 7 years ago. We were in Sitka, Alaska. We went down to Mississippi at Gulfport. We were down there helping for about a week at that time. Went down to a small mission camp in Kentucky, and now our trip here. I think we're all interested in trying to help. You know, we're all members of a church who we do a lot of stuff in the Akron area, but it's nice to step out and see other areas and help other people that we don't normally see.
Hi, my name is Ed Gomez. I work for Credit Suisse. Several times a year, Credit Suisse and Habitat for Humanity partner together to provide volunteers in order to help restore houses such as this one. It's a great opportunity for our employees to be able to give back to the community and provide awareness of what Habitat for Humanity does for the community.
I'm Mel Hathaway. I'm the pastor of the Sonnenberg Mennonite Church in near Kidron, Ohio. And we have a group of fellows from the church there that decided we would get together and do a week's of service, and connected with MDS, Mennonite Disaster Service, and this is the project that they invited us to come and work at. So we're here at Staten Island, and we're trying to help out some people that need some help getting their houses back in shape so they're livable again. Mennonite Disaster Service is a nationally recognized organization, but we always try to partner with local folks that are working to improve the situation for people. And so for me as a volunteer, I don't have to know all the ins and outs of what's happening here. I come in, there's a supervisor here that's telling us where the jobs are and lining up the materials for us. And so that's real helpful. We'd have a hard time coming in and doing this kind of thing on our own, but to work through the organizations that are here, that makes it possible for us.
My name's Ned Mast. I'm from Worcester, Ohio, and I'm here with Mennonite Disaster Service, helping these homeowners rebuild their homes after Hurricane Sandy damage. I've done other trips before with Mennonite Disaster Service, but more in our local area in Northeast Ohio for other storm-related damages. We really enjoy the camaraderie that we have with our other volunteers, and it's a good chance to get away and help other people out in the process. Well, I didn't see the damage right after the hurricane, but I heard that these houses were all gutted and stripped down. We're working at putting drywall up today and working on some subfloor damage in the back where there was moisture that rotted out the joists. And looks like we have quite a good ways to go yet, but a lot of work's already been done. I'd encourage anyone that has two hands and is able-bodied to come out and volunteer. We can always use the help, and there's skilled laborers around to let everyone know what to do and keep things organized. But it's a good experience and a good way to meet new people and help your neighbors in the process.
My name is Gene Denlinger. I'm from Lancaster, Pennsylvania. I'm here in Staten Island helping to rebuild after Hurricane Sandy. I've been involved with some other relief efforts through Mennonite Disaster Service And it's something that I retired recently from my job, and I have more free time, so it's something I wanted to do when, as I'm able. It's not only beneficial to the people that you're helping, it's also very beneficial to yourself, just your whole self-esteem, just helping other people just really helps everyone.
Hi, my name is Jordan Lombardo. I'm here with Barron Builders in the Jersey Shore, working on some houses that were destroyed in Sandy. We're trying to get everything going. It's apparent that a lot more help is needed, so any volunteer effort that you can give, whether it's in the form of physical labor, monetary donations, or just following us and furthering our effort online at Jersey Shore Volunteers on any social media, is greatly appreciated. Thank you very much.
Please consider coming down to Camp Evans and help families in need. You really don't need any tools. You don't need any experience. I came down on these service trips, didn't know how to do anything. I learned how to paint. Today we learned how to sheetrock. And in my own way, I'm making a difference in someone's life. And I had no experience. So if I can do it, anyone can do it.
Jersey Shore Volunteers. Share your stories on your favorite social media platform using hashtag Jersey Shore Volunteers or use hashtag JSV.